Today on Typical Books, we have a hot cup of coffee, a gigantic butcher knife, and a massive stack of books for me to unbox. This is what has happened during the time that I was reading what I owned, and I won't gesture with the knife anymore. I'll set it down safely back where it was in the bookshelf. I have amassed quite a number of books. You'll see boxes from Book of the Month Club. There are ARCs, there are pre-orders, all kinds of things. Books that I had ordered before I started the challenge on November 5th, and I was inspired by Criminali, Ollie over at Criminali, who took this challenge. I'm also inspired by Michael K. Vaughn, who has been undergoing a Read What You Own challenge for quite some time. And I've learned a couple things about the Read What You Own challenge. It's great. It's worth it. I love it. I loved it. I also hated it. Because of this. It's not that I have trouble controlling my book buying. I do just have regular book buying, and I'm a creature of habit like so many people. And not that the Book of the Month Club is like a bad habit or anything there, but I had just started it and I didn't want to really stop it. I skipped a couple months. Some books did catch my eye, so I was very interested to get to those. New releases, I'm a sucker for. I mean, I curate the list of new releases at the Horror Writers Association website, so I see them and they're so enticing. If you think my channel's enticing, when it comes to books that I talk about, like some of these books and boxes are going to be of interest to some people, I'm sure. I see a lot of books that are so enticing. I have a lot of cool author friends that I want to buy their books when they come out. Luckily, I did get some ARCs during that time, and gifts were part of the exceptions. So I did get some gifts, like gifts for my husband, and I got gifts, just gifts of ARCs, and I have like review copies, so I count those as gifts as well. But yeah, otherwise there were some pre-orders and I just didn't open them because I didn't want to break the rules. And I'm sort of bending the rules now because I've got a couple books left to read, but I got a couple books on the go that I'm gonna finish, like Cold Black and Infinite by Todd Kiesling, which I am enjoying so much. Like, it is run, don't walk. I hope it wins awards because wonderful stuff. And I'm still just wrapping up the Carl Edward Wagner In a Lonely Place. I finished reading Hog, which was, I skimmed a lot of it because it's just not necessarily my thing, but I wanted to get it done and over with. And I'm also just wrapping up The Big Head. I think I just overlapped a whole bunch of books to get them read, right? But hey, here we are at the end of the challenge and the beginning of a huge unboxing. So without further ado, I'm going to try and not be too knifey in case some people are sensitive to a whole lot of knifey going on. And I'm also going to try to not stab the books, because that's not what you want to do, right? Have you ever gotten a book or something out of a box that has a great big blade mark in it? I think that's why I appreciate these larger knives, because they're a little easier for me to control in a way than a box cutter, which is extremely sharp and kind of a little much. This, I think because of like years and years as a human being preparing food in the kitchen, I have enough knife safety. Box cutter safety is not my forte. Oh yeah! There's going to be a whole bunch of this, because I know what's in the boxes. I do. I know what's in the boxes. But some of them I forget and I don't know what's in what box. This is also part of the rush to get the unboxing done, is that I have an order, a pre-order, that I think is in here, but I'm not sure. And I want to make sure it wasn't stolen off of my doorstep. It might be arriving today. A Flicker in the Dark, Stacey Willingham. This was one of the few thriller books at Book of the Month Club that caught my eye. I might not continue with Book of the Month Club after the next couple months. We'll see if anything else really works for me, because these are just kind of summer reads. The Resort, Sarah Oakes. This is specifically for summertime. I want to read something summery in summertime, and this looks like it will be the one for me. So yeah, some Book of the Month Club thrillers that I'm very interested in. I've heard a lot of good about A Flicker in the Dark. Okay. So what have we next? We have, this will be an ARC, I believe. It's a big box. I don't know. I'm worried. Like, what if I accidentally open up someone's Christmas presents, or what if I accidentally show you what I'm getting someone for their birthday? We'll find out. And I hope it isn't too bad of the ASMR in this as well. Oh my, I feel like I'm quartering a pig. It's a big box. I wonder if there's swag. Just a lot of really good packaging. I know what this is, and I know why it's such a big box, because there's two books in here, and it's domestic. Not domestic as in violence, but domestic as in from Canada. ECW Press had asked me if I was interested in either of these books, and I said, oh my, I am very interested in both. When I saw that they were coming out this year, they were on my list to purchase: Grey Dog by Elliot Gish and Withered by A.J.A. Wilmot. And Withered has such a gorgeous cover. I am very intrigued by Grey Dog, and this sounds like it will be just sublime, dark as anything. So yes, a subversive literary horror novel that disrupts the tropes of women's historical fiction with illusions, wild beasts, and an uncontainable power of female rage. So yes, and a queer paranormal horror novel in the style of showrunner Mike Flanagan, showing the complex real-life terror inherent in grief and mental illness. Very, very, very fascinated to read these, and I'll have reviews coming up soon because these will be second on my list of reading. What will be number one on my list of reading, you ask? I think it's in this box. We'll find out in 1 second. It is supposed to get extremely cold today. It's been unseasonably warm, and it's going to drop all of a sudden 20 degrees after dinner tonight. So I want to get all of these unboxed and into the recycling as soon as I can. Oh, come on. If I wasn't so afraid of cutting the tops of my books, I would use a box cutter like a normal person, but I just can't. What I wish I had was that wonderful jade knife that Merce from Harpies in the Trees would use. Okay, here we go. This book will be number one on my reading, and you may think I'm holding it upside down, but I'm not. My Throat and Open Grave by Tori Bovolino. This is the patron pick, so hurrah! Thank you so much for voting, everyone who voted. They say he's the devil, the lord of the wood, with gnarled skin like roots of trees and eyes of a wolf, ready to open his jaws and swallow a young girl whole. I was so intrigued by the premise of this. Reminds me of something like Brahm. It's folk horror, and it's going to be quite dark. So I'm very, very intrigued to read this. I love this cover art. Love it so much. This gorgeous red bloody handprint on the nightgown of a girl, photographed upside down. Really unsettling to begin with. That will be the first book I pick up after I'm done the Read What You Own challenge, with those three books left to go, which I've been reading here and there through work, on breaks, in the morning time, stuff like that. Yeah, I'll be done reading those soon, very soon, and starting my Throat and Open Grave, and having a new poll come up on Patreon very, very soon. Indeed, the next video I'm going to make is a new releases video, so I will have a whole bunch of new books to talk about soon. Hopefully I won't be too tempted because I've got a lot to read on the go. This is another arc. Another reason I am entrusting my books to the knife is that I have had the longest nails I've ever had lately, and I don't want to ruin them. Man, Amazon really ought to take a note from booksellers on how to package books. This is pristine. There's hardly any damage to the corners of the books. All the other books have been really well packaged. I was surprised the Amazon one was actually fine, but I think it's because the book actually fit the box perfectly, so it didn't get damaged. I had too many damaged hardcover books from Amazon. This is, as advertised, an ARC from Inkshare. So thank you, Noah, for sending Inkshare's books along. This is how I discovered Celso Hurtado's awesome series, which I'm very excited for more of, Ghost Tracks or The Devil's Promise by Celso Hurtado. This is Midwestern Gothic by Scott Thomas. I absolutely loved Kill Creek. I loved Kill Creek so much, I still think of it. Some of the characters really stuck out, and probably because it is a horror readers or horror writers novel. It's really about horror reading fiction, the people that create it and the people that read it, and the people that create the supernatural angle of it all. So this Midwestern Gothic is 4 novellas. I haven't read Violet, and I really ought to, but this is right up my alley. It's got these 4 amazing stories. The text is a little small, and I don't have my glasses right now, but The Boy in the Woods, Where You Are Secret Like a Stone, The Door in the Field, and One Half of a Child's Face are the titles of the stories in this. If you like Scott Thomas, tell me if this is on your list. Have you read Violet? I'm very interested because I loved Kill Creek so much. I have high hopes for Midwestern Gothic. I've already got like a really big stack of books here, don't I? Well, we've got more to come. Maybe I'll do this little tiny package first to give the knife a break. Oh, I lied. I need a knife for this. This is Waif by Samantha Kolesnik, whose last name I always have trouble pronouncing. I always feel like I'm doing it right, but then part of me feels like I'm doing it wrong. But yeah, Waif. I've been so excited to read this, and of course it was delayed for me. And Off Limits Press, who published this, is also publishing, has republished True Crime. So if you missed out on reading that and were looking for it, it's out again. So check out Off Limits Press. I also have Bella Station here on my to read that came in right when I had started my Read What You Own challenge. So I'm like, well, I don't technically own it yet, do I? Do I? But yeah, nice thin book too. I wish I had it during the challenge when I was looking for novellas. But yeah, Waif. I so badly want to take a sip of my coffee. Okay, so this is another Book of the Month Club. And this is one that I'd be not watching one of Sin's book reviews from Sin's Book Nook so that I can actually read it first and then watch reviews. I can hear the bookmark rattling around in here. I like the very plain little Book of the Month Club bookmarks. I really do. Book of the Month, close to the climax, huh? I guess it's, you're supposed to use this bookmark when you're in the middle. I don't really get it. Is it a sex thing? I don't really get it. But yes, okay, so what have we got? Season's Readings. May your books be merry and bright. It's been this long. This is No One Can Know, a novel by Kate Alice Marshall, and it's yet another one of those books that have a novel in the title of the novel. I do enjoy that quite a bit. Houses on the cover. This is going to be a theme. When I finally get all these unboxed, we have one more box to go, I'm going to see how many houses are on the cover of these books. Because you know I really do enjoy houses on the cover of a book for whatever reason. And now I want to see if I got bookmarks in the other Book of the Month Club box. Oh, it was. It was underneath the flaps. It had wiggled its way under the flaps. Book of the Month. Was it something I read? You have to say it in that, you know, oh, was it something I read? Oh, it probably was. Probably was. That should be like the slogan of my show. Oh, why'd you unsubscribe? Was it something I read? Or something I didn't read? So last box. Oh my god. Thank you for sticking it out through this entire stack of amazing discoveries. It turns out that the book that I was hoping had already been delivered should be in this box. And if it's not, then there may be another addendum to this. It is in the box. I'm so happy because I was so worried someone stole this book. For whatever reason, it is extremely expensive to get this in Canada right now. I don't know why. Tim McGregor's Iron Hallow. It is a Bride of Frankenstein story that is getting really great reviews. I've listened to a lot of podcasts talk about it. Podcast interviews with Tim McGregor. Amazing dude. I'm very, very excited. This is a gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous hardcover. Put out by Raw Dog Screaming Press. It's just out now. I mean, it was a pre-order that I've been sitting on. I think I ordered it in mid-December. And yeah, so wow. That is quite a collection. As far as books with houses on the cover, Iron Hallow is not one. No One Can Know is one. Waif does not. Midwestern Gothic surprisingly does not. My Throat an Open Grave does not. Withered does. Grey Dog does not. The Resort does not. And A Flicker in the Dark does not. I'm surprised. Okay. So I did pretty good. Two books with houses on the cover. I thought it would be like half of them. So I'm going to see how this fits in to my review copy reading. That's three review copies of books I'm very excited to read that are here. One's a little long. Gray Dog looks long. I didn't look at to see how big the text is. But yeah, I shouldn't be like that. I know I'll rip through it. I've loved everything I've read from ECW Press, and I know I'll love this. So it's slim, so is Waif. Maybe I will read them after I'm done reading the patron pick. So yeah, I'll have a big list of books that are coming out soon from Horror Writers Association writers like Tim and a whole bunch of other authors, of course, and be fashioning a list that you could vote on as well at Patreon or as tiebreakers when there's a tie. I turn to everyone here. So thank you so much for watching and have an ooky, spooky day.